Summer brings more than just sun, amusement parks, and pool dates. It also allows kids more time to sleep in, bum around the house, and before you know it, they might even be saying, Mom, we're bored. We're talking about ways to keep your child's brain healthy, active, and stimulated during the summer vacation months. Right now, we're joined by parenting expert Mary Frances Bayer. You have some quick brain tips to keep kids going.
Yeah, you got it. One thing is I feel like kids nowadays, especially elementary school kids, we sit a lot. They sit in school. They deal with a lot of frustration. It's really important to, number one, get outside to move around, but also to be with nature. It's very regulating and calming for our brains and our bodies. So it doesn't have to be anything fancy. Go to a park, you know, go on a trail. It doesn't have to cost any money, but being with nature is great for our minds.
Even just your backyard.
Just your backyard.
That's right. So our first tip is definitely to kind of limit the screen time for your kids. It's okay if they want to use their screens, but not all day, every day.
Absolutely, because sometimes I think kids don't know how to occupy themselves when there is nothing to do. So going right to a screen kind of limits us. I always tell parents maybe like get a box of things for kids to do that you pull out for like a half hour a day so they can learn how to occupy themselves and be independent.
It's one of those things where with children being born into this world with so much technology available with them, parents may not realize that things are just so much different now than when they were growing up.
Yeah, a lot of kids have a hard time entertaining themselves without a screen. So it's important to learn that skill because you're going to be sitting waiting without a screen, like in the supermarket or the doctor. So it's a skill you have to learn.
Okay, productive play is also important. What do you mean by productive play?
A lot of kids sometimes were always consuming by playing video games. So productive play is like creating, like with blocks or characters, open-ended play where kids are doing a lot of trial and error and creating something.
And this might be a good place to bring in any of those day camps or summer activities, things where you're doing arts and crafts, where you're walking away with something that you made at the end of the day.
Exactly. It's
and
so great.
Things like I think of the Red Box and something that simple.
Right. It's perfect because, again, you're producing something.
That's right. Okay. And then we're also talking about academics. You don't want to just put all those books away forever. Right. Summer reading lists are important.
Yeah, a lot of parents now, because school is so rigorous, we need to keep it going all summer. And what I tell parents is, and what I'm doing is, try to do it first thing in the morning if that fits into your schedule so it's done. It doesn't have to be really intense, you know, 10 or 15 minutes, but you have to keep the academics going because they're going to go back in the fall and jump right back into it. And we don't want them to fall behind.
No, and those the summer reading lists or all those summer reading challenges can also help you work on that regimen so that you start it now and keep it going.
Right, and schools will give you something, too. Most schools offer, like, a curriculum for the summer.
Okay, so when you follow all those organizational tips from Jennifer earlier in the show, make sure that stays out with you for the summer. Yeah. And then our last tip here is just spending time together as a family.
Yes. I think we have to schedule that because, again, we're so busy. So it's important to say, okay, at this time on this day, we're going to do something together. Again, it doesn't need to be where you spend money. It just needs to be something that where you do and spend time together.
And we are spending time together with your family today, too. You have your little guys here. It's one of their first days of summer vacation. Guys, thanks so much for coming in today. How are you guys all going to spend? Well, first of all, reintroduce your sons to our viewers.
Okay. This is Joe is right on my lap. He's 7 and Charlie is 9.
And where do they go to school?
Where do you go to school?
Smallwood.
Smallwood Elementary. Yep. And they just had their last day of school a little bit earlier this week,
right? Yeah, on Tuesday. And